I'm Mr. Vinent. My experience here has been great.
Show, we have
I love students,
on the new teacher,
and
Mr.
the faculty
Vinent.
Has been wonderful.
And
I
information
teach
on the
English,
club fair.
And then I bounce around to
fair. So, what happens at the club fair?
Club fair is a very exciting
we
time.
We are making stories by teens, for teens. Creating a platform. Finding character. And giving others a voice. This is SVTV.
Howdy, Vikings. I'm Carson.
And I'm Ike.
And you're watching SVTV. Club fair will be today and tomorrow during CALP. Emery went and talked with Mr. Schmidt to get more information.
Hey, Vikes. I'm here with Mr. Schmidt, and he's going to talk to us about the club fair. So, what happens at the club fair?
The club fair is a very exciting time for all the students in the school. If you're already involved in a club, to go out and sell your club and tell everyone in the school, the younger underclassmen and also even upperclassmen that have never been involved before, what is so great about your club and why they should join your club. The club fair is very important for all the students to get involved in something at school here. We encourage all students to get involved at least in two activities or clubs. And there's a number of clubs. We have over 35 different clubs that you can be involved in. So you can find an interest in one of those things, surely. And it is a proven fact that students who are involved in extracurricular activities or clubs do better in academics. So it's important, very important to be here at school. And that's another big draw for students is if you're involved in something here at school, you're more likely to come to school that day. So it gets you at school, you also make friends. I mean, that's a great way to make friends and make acquaintances that may be lifelong friends, and then also you do better in academics. So it's a win-win-win for everyone that's involved.
All right, thanks, Mr. Schmidt. Now back to your anchors.
Hey, what clubs are you in?
I'm in FBLA.
Oh, so am I.
And we're wearing the same shirt, too.
Wow. Now to your announcements with Ike.
No.
If you're interested in Scholars Bowl, tryouts will be held in room 920 from 7:15 a.m. to 7:45 a.m. on September 9th and 10th. Mrs. Noble is offering students an opportunity to participate in a job shadow experience. There are some restrictions which you will find on Schoology. Applications are being accepted now through October 31st for first semester visits. Students interested in the medical profession, the University of Kansas Health System is starting a medical explorer class that begins Monday, September 23rd from 7 to 8:30 p.m. Look at the flyers around school for more information. ACT prep classes are now available. Visit the office to register. Registration and payment due by October 18th. We went and interviewed the new teacher, Mr. Vinent, to learn more about him.
I'm Mr. Vinent. My experience here has been great. I love the students and the faculty has been wonderful. I teach English and then I bounce around to a bunch of inclusion classes. My goal is just to become a better teacher and to help influence the students here at Seaman High School. Go Vikings!
Students, go to SeamanNews.com to take a poll about the schedule to give us some feedback. It's not going. Okay. Mr. McAllister is planning a trip to Boston and New York this year, and a trip to Italy next year. If you're interested in signing up for any of these trips, come to the school library September 7th at 6 p.m. to see Mr. McAllister for more details. Speed limit and radar checks. Students, remember that the speed limit in the parking lot is 10 miles per hour. The Superintendent's Student Advisory Council is looking for applications. If you want to fill one out, please see your Class of Schoology page to apply. Picture day will be on September 16th and 17th during English classes. Seniors, if you don't have an English class, please see Mrs. Riley in C2 to schedule your picture. That's all for your announcements. Now over to Ike with the sports.
Are you late, man?
Sorry, I was signing up for clubs, like foreign language club. And I'm really happy about this club.
And then?
I signed up for fishing club.
And then?
Oh, and then I signed up for book club.
And then?
Next, I signed up for our club.
And then?
And then I became a family leader joining FCCLA.
And then?
Finally, I joined Dungeons & Dragons Club. And that's not even half of the clubs. There's so many you can join.
Blue Out is the Spirit Club theme for Friday's football game at home against Highland Park. Our golf team took second at our Invitational yesterday. Molly McLaughlin placed 10th, Molly Biggs placed 9th, and special congrats to Lois Dieter for winning the tournament with a round of 75. Soccer will be playing Free State at home tonight at 6:15. Volleyball is having a meet at home starting at 5. The wrestling team will be holding a kickball classic on Sunday, September 29th at the Seaman Middle School football field. Cost is $80 per team and the registration deadline is September 20th. Complimentary lunch will be served. That's all for sports. Let's go see what Josh has for us with the weather.
Can you believe it's already Thursday? Here's what we're looking at for the weather today. You can see it's going to be another hot one with highs around 91 degrees and temperatures in the upper 80s to low 90s throughout the rest of the afternoon and into the evening. So the soccer game is going to be pretty hot. But the good news is that for tomorrow, a cold front will have moved through and the football game tomorrow night looking very pleasant, mostly clear skies with temperatures in the 70s, so it's going to be comfortable for your Friday night football. Now, as we head into the weekend, there is a chance we look at some scattered showers and thunderstorms. This is Saturday night through Sunday evening. Most of the activity is going to be in northern Kansas and Nebraska. We could see some as far south as Topeka, so we'll be monitoring that again Saturday night through Sunday evening. Now we still have to talk about Dorian because it is just pounding the South Carolina coastline right now with hurricane force winds, and hurricane warnings are in effect for the South Carolina and North Carolina coastlines. It actually might make landfall in one of those states over the next day or so before it quickly moves out and away finally from the United States. That has been quite the ride with Dorian. Here's your 7-day forecast. You can see we do cool down for tomorrow with highs in the middle 80s, and then Saturday and Sunday highs will start to climb back up to the upper 80s with some storms possible again Saturday night through Sunday evening. And also don't forget you can get your forecast anytime in a written version at seamannews.com. Just click on the weather tab. Now, Ike and Carson, back to you.
That's all for today, Vikes. Tomorrow we have two new teacher features. See you later.
I hate this chair.
Ow, ow.